In today's video, we are taking you through the 2010 American science fiction horror film, The Crazies. Spoilers ahead, you have been warned. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, comment on what your favorite part was, and subscribe to our channel for more. The movie is set in a small fictional town of Ogden Marsh, Iowa. The residents of the town suddenly start exhibiting bizarre behavior. A middle-aged man by the name of Rory Hamill enters a high school baseball game with a shotgun. He has blood coming out of his nose. The sheriff of Pierce County, David, and his deputy Russell are present at the scene. Sheriff David tries to defuse the situation. He tries to talk to Rory, who he personally knows, into disarming himself. However, Rory doesn't seem to be in the right state of mind. He has a weird look on his face and doesn't listen. David assumes that Rory might have had too much to drink. The situation escalates as Rory tries to aim his gun at David. Sensing a threat to his life, David shoots him in the chest. David requests information about the level of alcohol in Rory's system. He then meets Rory's family to offer his condolences. He apologizes to his wife for shooting him. She reveals that he had quit alcohol 2 years ago. The next day, the medical examiner, Jim, lets David know that Rory didn't have alcohol in his system. A woman named Deandra and her family visit David's pregnant wife, Judy, at her clinic. Judy is a family doctor. Deandra tells Judy that her husband, Bill, isn't well. Bill seems lost in his thoughts and has a similar strange look on his face as Rory did. Judy examines Bill. A tuned-out Bill snaps out of his thoughts and tells Judy that he is a bit tired but overall fine. Judy can't ascertain the problem. She decides to wait it out until the following Monday before she runs a CT scan on him. She then drives off to see a patient in Cedar Rapids. The movie then cuts to Bill's home. His wife and son are puzzled by the loud sound of the crop harvesting machine running in the middle of the night inside their farm garage. She leaves her son inside the house to inspect the garage but doesn't find Bill. She then hears the sound of her son Nicholas screaming. She swiftly runs towards her home. She finds her frightened son upstairs, who tells her that Bill is walking around with a knife. Fearing for their life, she hides Nicholas and herself inside a closet. Bill finds them hiding in the closet and locks them inside. He then starts pouring gasoline all over the house as his wife pleads to him to let them out. He then strikes a match and burns his wife and son to death. Sheriff David and Judy arrive at the scene to find an apathetic Bill handcuffed, whistling on the back of a pickup truck. Some people find a dead body in the Hotman Bogland while hunting. Later, it is found to be the body of an army pilot. Russ tells Sheriff David that last week he heard a guy mention hearing the sound of a plane crash nearby Hotman Bog. They set out on a boat to investigate the area. They find a vast military plane submerged in the water. David grows suspicious of the cargo that the plane was carrying, as oddly, there wasn't any media coverage of any such army plane crashing into the river. A spy satellite watches as the crashed military plane is discovered and a so-called containment protocol is activated. David and Russ, upon further investigation, later learn the treated water from the river that eventually ends up as the drinking water for the town's residents coincidentally gets to Rory Hamill's house first. This leads David to suspect the plane's cargo contaminated their water supply, which could have caused the town's strange behavior. David then cuts off the water supply of the town. Back at the police station, Russ and David then find a bleeding Bill lying unconscious, presumably dead in his jail cell. As they approach his cell, he wakes up and tries to attack them. David starts to smell something fishy. The request to transfer Bill to Cedar Rapids County still hasn't been followed through. The internet, telephone, and mobile connections of the town are out of service all at the same time. David then ventures out to find an eerie, deserted town. He discovers a shady black car monitoring him from afar. He approaches the car, but it swiftly flees. David then goes to check up on Jim, the medical examiner. He finds a live man with a stitched mouth and eyes. As he tries to help him out, Jim attacks him from behind. A crazed Jim tries to kill David with a bone cutter, but David eventually neutralizes him. Moments later, armed soldiers wearing gas masks storm the town. They put all the town residents into large school buses and take them to the local high school. The school has been turned into a quarantine facility. The temperature of all residents is noted. People with elevated temperatures are forcefully segregated from people with average temperatures. David passes the infection test, but Judy does not. The army takes Judy and the other infected people to a makeshift medical facility. They are strapped to their beds and tests are run on them. The entire facility is guarded by armed soldiers. Meanwhile, David and the other non-infected residents are greeted by non-masked soldiers and given identity bands. They are then lined up to be put on trucks to be evacuated from the town. An uprising happens at the heavily guarded infected camp. A civilian vehicle runs over the security gate. The infected residents break out of the quarantine facility. The soldiers, unable to contain the riot, sense a possible spread of infection and decide to abandon the area immediately. The soldiers then board the military helicopters and shoot any infected civilians. David decides to stay back and look for his pregnant wife, Judy. Along with Russell, he goes back to the camp where the infected residents had been kept. The principal of the local high school, Bill Sanborn, seemed to have been taken completely over by the infection. With no soldiers to secure the area and most residents still strapped to their beds, he goes on a bloody rampage. A strapped Judy and her assistant, Becca, nervously watch him kill people from their beds. Just as Bill is about to stab Judy in the stomach, David shoots him dead. The four then attempt to escape from the ravaged Ogden Marsh, while avoiding the soldiers ordered to execute all non-soldiers and the increasingly violent infected. They look for a getaway vehicle. Most vehicles have been booted by the military to prevent the infected residents from leaving town. David then decides to repair and use an old defunct vehicle parked in his garage at home. On their way there, they pass through Becca's boyfriend Steve's home. The military storms his house and kills Steve and his mother. They then burn their dead bodies as the four watch it unfold while hiding in Steve's barn. The following morning, they reach David's home. Becca and Russ try to repair the defunct vehicle as David and Judy go inside their home. David loads essentials in a bag to carry with them for the long journey. Judy goes upstairs to take one final look at her baby's nursery. Suddenly, she is held hostage in the nursery by the wife and son of Rory Hamill, who David had shot at the beginning of the movie. They have been infected by the virus and want to avenge Rory's death. David finds Judy in the nursery tied up. A bloody struggle ensues, and eventually David and Russ manage to kill both of them. Observing Russ's unusually violent and aggressive behavior, Judy starts suspecting that the virus may have infected him. However, David brushes it off and they carry on their journey. A military helicopter flies over their car, forcing them to hide in the nearby car wash. As they wait for the helicopters to leave, the car wash automatically starts running. The conveyor belt renders their car immobile, and the water, soap, and large brushes cloud their sight. In a matter of seconds, they are surrounded by crazed town residents. A grisly struggle follows. David manages to get the car out of the car wash, but the infected people pull Becca out by tying a noose around her neck, ultimately killing her. As they all get out to check on Becca, an army chopper bombs their getaway car. They set out on foot on the highway. Russ notices a black car passing. He spikes its tire and derails the car. They subdue an intelligence officer in the car, who reveals the cargo plane contained a biological weapon called Trixie, which contaminated the town's water source. It is a U.S. Army-engineered biological weapon intended to destabilize a population. The plane was headed to an incinerator in Texas, but accidentally crashed in the town's river. He also reveals that the infection has an incubation period of 48 hours, after which a person either recovers or dies from it. An increasingly violent Russell begins to act abnormal and executes the intelligence officer. This causes tension between Russell and David. Russell then realizes that he is infected. The group then reaches the only road to the truck stop, which is being blocked by soldiers. Russell, aware of his inevitable impending doom, offers to provide a distraction. David and Judy bypass the soldiers as Russ distracts the soldiers and ultimately gets killed. The couple arrives at the deserted truck stop. David finds the getaway trucks meant to evacuate non-infected residents still parked at the empty station. Judy notices scores of bullet shells on the floor. Upon further inspection, they discover the charred dead bodies of all their non-infected neighbors who were supposed to have been evacuated. They realize that the U.S. Army is going to kill them whether they are sick or not. They decide to take one of the parked trucks to escape. While doing necessary preparations to leave, David overhears military communication through an abandoned mobile radio of a soldier. It is a communication between a military command post and a military aircraft about a scheduled event set to take place in 10 minutes. After killing more of the infected who attacked them and anticipating an imminent threat from the military, they frantically free the town in a semi-truck. As they escape, they overhear a countdown on the wireless military mobile radio. At T-minus zero, everything goes silent. A bright light takes over the place, followed by the sound of a massive explosion. A mile-high mushroom smoke cloud rises out of Ogden Marsh. The town has been annihilated by a U.S. military nuclear bomb. the ripples from the gigantic blast send David and Judy's truck flying off the highway. With their truck disabled, David and Judy, still alive and hopeful, head towards Cedar Rapids on foot. Just as the couple approaches Cedar Rapids, they are spotted by a satellite. Yet another so-called containment protocol is initiated by the Army. The movie ends here. Thanks for watching the video till the end. Do like the video if you enjoyed it, and please subscribe to our channel to see more movie summaries like this.